The Duchess of Cambridge performed her third outfit change of the day as she arrived for a reception at Belfast's iconic Empire Music Hall on Wednesday night. Kate and William, who arrived in the city for a surprise visit to the city this afternoon, donned their finery for a party celebrating young people making a difference in Northern Ireland. The Duchess, 37, stunned in a £1,590 Missoni metallic knit wrap dress featuring a mid-length pleated skirt, just hours after donning her sport gear for an impromptu football match. The mother of three paired the powder blue gown with her signature Gianni Vito suede stilettos, costing £505, and a nude mulberry clutch, as she was greeted by Lord Lieutenant of Belfast Fionnuala J. O'Boyle. She finished off her look with a £1,500 amethyst pendant and matching £2,100 earrings by Kiki McDonough. A band called Larks will take to the stage tonight, and guests will encompass representatives from Northern Ireland's business, arts and sports sectors, including Dame Mary Peters, who was today appointed Lady Companion of the Most Noble of the Garter by the Queen. In a speech, William praised Dame Mary Peters' work for the common good and said many could learn from her example. He said, "Catherine and I are grateful to be amongst so many inspirational young leaders this evening. Over the course of the day, we've had the great privilege of meeting some of you personally and seeing firsthand the work that you are doing. From using sport to encourage people to talk openly about mental health to delivering services to children and young people who are at risk of entering care or custody, the work you do transcends community divisions and is helping deliver a brighter future for everybody in Northern Ireland. And as we celebrate those who are leading that change for the next generation, it is also fitting that we recognize somebody else in the room this evening, who helped inspire so many of you in the first place. Mary Peters is not only one of the United Kingdom's sporting legends, she's also inspired generation after generation to come together in times of trouble and work for the common good, a lesson I hope many of us can learn from. So it was fitting today that Her Majesty the Queen has appointed Mary to be a Lady Companion of the Most Noble Order of the Garter, one of the UK's highest honours. And I hope you can all join me in thanking and congratulating her personally this evening." The second in line to the throne was expected to use the opportunity to say Britain needs strong leadership, in a nod to the current deadlock at Westminster over leaving the EU. After his speech, Williams and Kate got behind the bar of the Empire Music Hall in Belfast, with Kate trying her hand at pulling a pint. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are spending Wednesday and Thursday carrying out a number of engagements in Belfast, Fermanagh and Ballymena. In keeping with royal visits to Northern Ireland, details were not released in advance and the itinerary was not disclosed beforehand for security reasons. The couple's focus on Wednesday was the benefits of sport and outdoor life on childhood development. They showcased their own skills during a kickabout at Belfast's Windsor Park Stadium, home of the Irish Football Association, which runs programs to encourage young girls to play the sport and to support clubs dealing with mental health issues. William and Kate were greeted by scores of cheering schoolchildren and stopped to chat with the crowds, with the Duchess being presented with a number of bunches of flowers. During their visit to Windsor Park, they learned about initiatives to get more women in key decision roles within football and a program aimed at young people who are not in employment, education or training. They then traveled to the Rosker Youth Village Charity in Co-Fermanagh, which is a residential activity centre for children referred by social workers, before returning to Belfast. On a day of competition for the Royals, at the Rosker Youth Village, Kate and William went head-to-head in a canoeing race on Loch Earn. They were part of two teams which raced in Canadian canoes, with William's boat crowned the winner, reaching the marker a few seconds ahead of Kate's. On the visit to the centre, which is run by the charity Extern, Kate also helped assemble a tent before taking part in a game of archery. The Duchess missed her first shot, but with some tips from the children hit the target on her second attempt. Meanwhile, William's balance was tested as he walked across a low ropes assault course. Children urged him on until he made it to the end and they celebrated with a cheer. On the Windsor Park turf, the Duke and Duchess both had a go at dribbling drills, to the delight of the young footballers. Kate ran around a marked-out square, keeping the ball under control, and also jogged up and down on the spot, and at one point she hugged and comforted 9-year-old Jasmine Andrews after she became emotional about the occasion. During the visit, the couple learned more about the Irish Football Association's community football projects and its work breaking down some of Northern Ireland's traditional divides through sport. They met people involved in an initiative aimed at encouraging more women into key decision-making roles within the game and also chatted to youngsters involved in the Goal program, a project designed for those not in employment, education or training. William and Kate also heard about IFA workshops and education courses that help students develop life skills. They learned about the Stay Onside initiative, which works with criminal justice agencies in a bid to reduce offending rates. The Cambridges also heard more about the game of power chair, an adapted version of football for wheelchair users. As they left the stadium at the end of the visit, three school children presented the couple with three green Northern Ireland home shirts, with the names of their children George, Charlotte and Louis on the backs.